Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to our party HQ today. We've called you here because we are issuing a media release now, and after we finish with the contents of the release, we will take your questions. So I'll start off with the English version, and Mr. Lau will come on later with the Chinese. The Workers' Party has expelled Yaw Shin Leong from the party with immediate effect. The Workers' Party believes strongly in transparency and accountability and expects no less from our party members, especially our members of parliament. Shin Leong has been accused of several indiscretions in his private life. By continuing not to account to the party and the people, especially the residents of Hougang, he has broken the faith, trust, and expectations of the party and the people. This is a difficult and painful decision for us. Shin Leong has been a core member of the party leadership for more than 10 years and has made significant and unique contributions towards WP's growth. He has also served the residents of Hougang diligently. However, the council has decided that it is in the public interest to take this step. We also believe it is only fair to the Hougang residents that they have another opportunity to elect their Member of Parliament. We apologise for having to put them through a by-election. We wish to assure Hougang residents that they will continue to be served by the party until the by-election is called. The Meet the People sessions in Hougang will continue, with the other MPs covering. Residents are free to contact any WP MP for assistance. In addition, Town Council services will continue to be provided by their alternate Hougang Town Council. Finally, we wish to thank the public for their concern towards the party and for walking with us through this difficult period. I'd like now to pass over to Mr. Lau, who will make the release in Chinese.
Read this. 要有担当，肯负责。最近，大众传媒接二连三出现对饶兴隆种种严重的指控，他选择不回应，也不出来解释清楚，是不负责任的行为，也造成了信任危机。后岗是捍卫新加坡民主政治的先锋。 没有后岗20年来的支持，工人党就不会有今天的发展，新加坡也不会在民主的过程中迈步前进。我们不能够辜负后岗选民的支持和期望，因此决定开除饶兴隆，让后岗选民可以再次做出决定。 由于这个事件使得后岗人感到困扰，也造成后岗区需要补选，我向后岗选民道歉。我也感谢在这困难时期不离不弃与我们共同奋斗的新加坡人。从现在开始一直到补选，在后岗每周
So perhaps we can open up for questions. Yeah, Imelda?
Could you give us some background as to what exactly led the party to this decision and why did it take you so long to come up with the party?
Mr. Yaw, you mean?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, this is obviously a complex matter, and the party leadership had very limited information in the first place. And of course, when we make decisions like this, we do not take it lightly, because it has implications not just on the party, but also on the residents of Hougang and perhaps on Singapore generally. So the party would need to go through its process and make a collective decision as best as it can as the situation has unfolded. Yeah, Wei Cheng. We had a meeting and a decision was taken. Yeah.
When was the decision made?
Last night.
It is, of course, indeed a very difficult decision to make, and it is disappointing. Although he has made his contribution to the party in the past, however, the party believes in transparency and accountability. We cannot compromise the basic fundamental principle which we believe in. Although it is a difficult decision, and it's a painful one to make, we will have to make so that the Workers' Party and its MPs can stand tall, can hold the head up to take the PAP government to account.
As we said earlier, the reason for the CEC's decision is our basic belief in the importance of transparency and accountability. And the CEC took this decision because, as mentioned, in the face of these allegations made, Shin Leong has not come forward to address them. And we feel that this falls short of what we expect, especially of an elected MP. I think this is a decision that Mr. Yaw, as an adult, has to make, and we have to expect him to make his own decision on this.
But would this not, in a way, let
I beg your pardon? Can you repeat your question?
By doing this, are you not worried that you're actually opening a can of worms such that voters may have a lot of thoughts surrounding all these allegations that they are
making? No, as we have said, we're taking this decision because we have certain expectations as far as accountability and transparency are concerned. We are not making any statement about whether the allegations are true or not, but we are saying that we expect, especially our MPs, to be responsible. So that's the reason why we're taking the decision, and we feel it's only fair for the Hougang voters to have another chance to make that decision. We invited Shin Leong to come to speak with us, but he has not done so. I'd rather not go into all these details, okay? But I can assure you that the due process was followed. No. Dates as in what?
By-election.
We are not in control of the by-election, so the Prime Minister has to decide when to call
it. Is there any indication, like, usually after how long?
This is an interesting question that was debated in Parliament before, and under our constitution, there's no written time limit for when the by-election can be called. But of course, our own expectation is that in an SMC, we feel that the need will be quite apparent, so that's up to the Prime Minister to tell us the date.
How confident is the party in keeping the Hougang seat?
I don't think we want to speculate how Hougang voters will vote, but we have to make this decision so that voters in Hougang have another opportunity to decide.
Thank you.
你讲的是后岗的是哪里？
就是整个共产党。
啊？
整个共产党还有后岗。你说选民的支持度还是？
我想我们没有办法判断支持度的影响，我们做这个决定也不是单单是支持度的问题，是原则上的问题。我们要求议员必须负责任，所以有了这样的一个报道跟传闻，不出来澄清，那是不负责任的行为。我们不允许这样的议员继续当议员下去。
I don't think we want to go into these details. I mean, the purpose of our announcement today is actually to tell you all that we have made a decision to expel Shin Leong because he has not addressed the allegations. At the moment, she is, but I'd like to stress that these remain allegations. I mean, there's no doubt that attention has been drawn to the party, and we are, of course, cognizant of that. But at the same time, we are also firm in our own beliefs about what we expect of our party members and of our MPs. And the action that we've taken may be no doubt deemed by some to be very drastic, but we feel that this is something necessary for us to do, and it is in the public interest for us to do that. And we'd like to assure the party, the public in that sense, that we are serious in our commitment to maintain high standards. Yes, Shenri? I don't think it is the party leadership's prerogative because the party leadership also was not cognizant of many of the facts. So we were not in a position really to address the substance of the allegations. I mean, as we mentioned just now, the key point is that there were some allegations made against Shin Leong's private life, several allegations, and we feel that we have to expect our elected MPs to address the allegations in a responsible manner. And unfortunately, we do not think that in this case our expectations have been met, and we think that the public also deserves to have them addressed. Can you repeat your question again?
How many times has the party tried to approach Mr. Yaw for him to address this matter?
I don't think we want to go into the number of times, but what I can tell you is that we have asked him to come to speak to the council on these things, and he has not done so. You mean, I beg your pardon?
Some online reports have said that some of the party CC members were actually aware of the allegations before they surfaced online and allegations. So, did you address this? And if that is not true, when did the party first come?
Well, from what I know, we received some queries from the media. So, that was the first time that we were aware that the media was looking into this matter. Apart from that, I don't think I can answer for our other members. No. Probably it will be confirmed on nomination day of the by-election. Yeah.
Well, you know, at the, after a candidate is chosen or selected by the party, there is always an opportunity for that individual to make it clear to the party whether there's anything that he or she would like to reveal about himself, any indiscretion, anything whatsoever. The fact of the matter is, you know, I think DPMT also repeated it in Parliament yesterday. You can only make an assessment on the basis of the information that you have and what people tell you and what your own assessment, what your own judgment is. Now, if this person turns into something that is not what your party stands for, then some hard decisions have to be taken.
In any case, I think you know that there's no selection process which is foolproof. So, of course, we have our own due diligence processes, but there is a limit, of course, to how far this can, you know, guarantee that nothing will ever happen. As we mentioned in the press release and what we just said just now, our assessment is that he has fallen short of the standards we expect in terms of responsible behaviour. In the face of these allegations, we would expect especially our elected members to come forward to address the allegations, not only to the party leadership but also to the public. And that is the reason why we feel that he has not met what we expect, and he's being expelled. He was not there. He was invited to come for the meeting, but he didn't. He was informed of the fact that the CC was meeting to discuss this matter, and he was invited to come to address the CC on whatever he deemed fit, but he chose not to come. You mean of the decision? Well, this morning I spoke to his wife, who is in contact with him because I could not contact him, and she told me that they are aware of it, of the decision. I do not know, but I am confident that they are aware of it. I'll be there. You see, because we are not in a position to confirm or disconfirm whether the allegations are true or not, but we expect our MPs to have a high standard of responsibility. So in this instance, based on the facts of this case, we do not believe that he has been accountable and transparent.
What does the party have to say about the moral values that
the MPs or the members of the Parliament have to hold? I mean, of course, I think each of us have our own standards and expectations, and of course there could be some variations also in the public about what is okay or not okay. But whatever it is, for this particular incident, as mentioned by Mr. Lau also just now, the fundamental thing for us also is that transparency and accountability is key. And in this case, it has not been met. No, I think we also had met monthly. I think that was made known to the public as well. So earlier in the month, there was the regular monthly meeting.
So my question is actually really, was it the first time that he was given a chance to explain council
or project? Anyway, this matter, as you know, has been going on for quite a number of days, you know, and there was no prohibition whatsoever for him to meet with the council in any way.
So yesterday, was there any voting or any sort going on to whether expel Mr. Yaw and
Okay, Gerald, you want to answer that?
The Workers' Party CEC makes its decisions collectively. So, as in the case of all major decisions that we take, we do take a vote. And so, yes, there was a vote taken, which is our normal procedure for important decisions in this. The decision was not unanimous, but there was the party members have the CEC members got their chance to air their concerns, and I think it's a good sign that it's not the decision on these kind of things is not driven by one person, but it's a collective decision that's taken by the whole council, and the whole council will be accountable for that decision that's taken.
What are some of the concerns had by the CEC?
I'm not going to go into the details of what we discussed. Same thing, I'm not going to go into those details.
So what I can tell you is that there's a clear majority for the motion to expel Yaw from the party.
Point was the newspaper reports that started coming out, I believe, on the Thursday. We had a new paper report and I believe some reports in the Chinese media of other personalities, other women, and at that point the party realized that there could be more individuals, and we were not in the know of what information was in the hands of the media, who are these women, what are the details. We did not know any of that, but our concern was previously it was just one individual, and there's scope when you have one individual for Yaw to have come out and accounted himself to the people in a responsible manner. But with more individuals coming to the fore, we did not feel that keeping quiet was an option anymore. The obligation to be upfront with the people, to be upfront with the party, to the voters, took a new turn. And he continued in his course of action to remain silent. And as stressed by Chairman, we did not feel that was in keeping with the standards the Workers' Party expects from its elected MPs.
Okay, that's a good question. Anyway, the WP Constitution has an article, 22, which allows the council to consider certain actions to be taken against members if, for example, it finds that the member has behaved in a way that is contrary to either the aims or objects of the party or has acted in such a way that prejudices the welfare of the party. So council made those deliberations with the article in mind. Under the procedure, there is a possibility for him, under the Constitution, to appeal to our Kata conference, and that is of course open to him.
公民党有一套遴选的制度，就遴选候选人。而我跟饶兴龙的关系基本上是在党跟工作上的关系。而我的原则是，你必须尊重个人的隐私，而也没有理由。虽然他如果有什么事件的话，应该 坦白的说，不过，我没有这个理由去，问那些很隐私的事情，我必须尊重个人的隐私。 我已经告诉你了嘛，不过显明我看也会理解吧，对吗？通常呢，当然我不清楚这个事情的来龙去脉，不过问题是，这种事情的发生，有时候我想连他身边最亲密的人都可能都不知道，你能够期待外人知道吗？
'Cause the question earlier on, it is a painful decision, but it's a necessary one to take it for the party to move forward and to be effective in taking the BAP government to account.
<音><音>不影响啊，我们党里面有很多年轻的领导人，他是其中的一个。
Legal question, actually, whether it's possible for one of the alternate MPs to go over. It's not possible. Yeah. What about them? Anything is possible, of course. And of course, the choice will be made known on nomination day of the by-election. The first time when he resigned, I mean, he tendered his resignation, so that was his action, and the council at that time deemed it appropriate to accept his assessment, so the resignation was accepted.
You're referring to the initial resignation from party leadership, right?
Okay. He was not there. Any other questions you want to ask?
So now you have taken care of Hougang for 2 decades or so, the Yaw's views for the last 10 years or so. You have mentioned that town council services will carry on, the MPs will carry on the MPs. But do you think that, are you confident there will not be any breakdown in the kind of care that's needed for residents in Hougang?
Yes, I'm confident from now till the by-election is called, and the new MP is in place. Well, you will know in due course.
Are you expecting to compete against one of your candidates against Shin Leong?
We will not want to speculate on what will happen. Yeah.
I don't think we're going to speculate anything that is hypothetical. So please ask questions with a fact, rather hypothetical.
That's hypothetical.
How do you know he has an intention?
Yeah, sure.
Maybe I'll put it another way. Does the Constitution allow party feedback members?
Of course, but you know, when the party decides to accept members, we also have to make an assessment about whether that person will be able to fit into the organization and its aims and goals. So, you know, I mean, as mentioned, we don't want to dwell on hypotheticals, but each membership will have to be reassessed. I can't remember.
Not I can recall of, but there were members who resigned on his own accord due to certain things, but not to the extent of expelling members.
So this is the first time
that he is expelling? As far as I know, but I don't know prior to me whether there was such action taken by the WP. But as far as I can recall, I think that's the first time.